we didn't really give the Obama administration enough time. 8 years wasn't enough. There was something beginning to happen that started under Holder and then Lynch at the Justice Department, where they began to prosecute corporations. You know, they put the private colleges, they didn't necessarily put them out of business, but they put a lot of private universities out of business. They're kind of putting private prisons out of business. And I was getting really optimistic that if Hillary became president, this would continue and we'd see something that we really have not seen for decades. I don't even think we saw it under the Clinton administration, where the Justice Department began to say, okay, if corporations are people, then the people in those corporations are, well, not going to go to prison, but they're going to be fined. We're going to go after them. We were beginning to see that recently, weren't we?
Yeah, absolutely.
And we're not going to see that now. This is a new, he's basically putting people in charge of cabinet positions that they want eliminated. For example, Rick Perry, the former governor of Texas, the longest serving governor of Texas. He's been nominated to run the Department of Energy. That's the department he couldn't remember. He had three departments he wanted to eliminate during his 2012 debate oops moment. So it's always good for Exxon when a mouth breather is running energy. Why is this especially good for Exxon if this specific intellectual lightweight, Rick Perry, is running energy?
Yes, running energy and our nuclear weapons as well. A lot of what nuclear energy is what they work on a lot there. So as kind of we've talked about a lot, all of these nominees in these kind of critical cabinet positions have been funded in their political roles by ExxonMobil, and Rick Perry's no different. He has taken $40,000 just in his most recent gubernatorial election from ExxonMobil. And in his role at Department of Energy, if he's confirmed, he would be, you know, overseeing a lot of research into ExxonMobil's competitors in alternative fuels and electric vehicles. And so that kind of stuff could really go away without funding being directed towards it.
You're listening to Highlights from the David Feldman Show, heard nationwide on Pacifica Radio, or as a podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, and now YouTube. Please subscribe to this channel. For more information, go to davidfeldmanshow.com. Thank you for listening.
The David Feldman Radio program is made possible by listeners like you. You sad, pathetic humps.